What I enjoy doing really is capturing, painting, that is my present contemporary culture, people, what the culture is, what I see in the culture. That's what I paint mostly. It interests me. It's amazing how the culture is, how if you look at the people going about, it's a vibrant, dynamic, everything moving. It's like chaotic. The market, the lorry stations, the streets, everything looks, if you look at it, it's chaotic. If you are a visitor, you're looking at it, you find, what is this? Everything's chaotic. It's like unplanned, unstructured, everything. But when I look at it, I think there's a structure. It's not that chaotic. People who live in it and work with it and they go about their daily activity in that chaotic situation, find the structure. It's as if it's planned, but it's not planned. And it is that planned, unplanned situation which excites my imagination, which is what I paint all the time. The markets, the lorry stations, the people in it, their characters. Those are the things that excite my imagination. And those are the things I work at. The future in art, yes. Ghana is tough, I must say. And if Ghana is tough, it's tough for the artist too, but it will be more so. Because where there is wealth, the artist enjoys some of it. That is, people have got to be all right to buy art. Otherwise, people don't buy art. So, you wish that you live in an area or within a community that people are prosperous. As prosperity comes in, it also reaches the artist. The artist gets to sell his things and makes a living. But I wish that these African countries, are prosperous. When they prosper, the artists will prosper. Where there is abject poverty, the artists will be particularly poor. That's what I think. That's where we start from, and that's where I started from. You got to do some work to keep body and soul together, to eat, to have a roof over your head. But they must make a living, and therefore the imparting of a soul, of yourself into a work of art, doesn't happen. We try to promote. I try very much. Very much so. I tell you, it's my thing that we promote art, so that anybody who enters this country, visits this place, would have a good bird's eye view of what art, contemporary art is. And today, it's like that for most artists. You've got to do some work to get some monthly salary to keep you together, and then you sell, you paint, and then possibly you are able to sell one or two paintings, yes. But that does not keep anybody. If you love the work, you keep on going, because you love, just simply love it, love working as an artist. And it's in time that you may or may not even, but you may get known. When you get known, people begin to ask, come to ask here, oh, can I see the work of Larry Otu? Then it means your name has got out there. But otherwise, it's a struggle all along. Like every artist everywhere, you've got to be known to live on the work. If we take the culture as an entirety, it's what the artist is trying to capture and is more or less preserved in their work. And therefore, if the artist is true to himself and true to what he's doing, then you'll find the culture coming through. It's evident in the artist's work. So that's what makes work of art art. That is the individual is in it. And therefore that individuality in art is universal. We are different and yet we show our personalities. For me, I see it as very vibrant, very great, absolutely great.